Hello. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to add databases in SAP Replication Server. To add an Adaptive Server Enterprise, or ASE, database to the replication system, you can use the RS init tool. In this video, I'll show you how to add a primary ASE database using RS init in GUI mode. Before you start, add the ASE server and the replication server to the interfaces file, and make sure both servers are running. First, run RS init from the start menu or the installation directory. Accept the default release directory and choose Configure a Server Product, then Replication Server. Next, select Add a Database to the Replication System. The order doesn't matter, but make sure to complete both options. I'll do Replication Server information first. Enter the replication server name, which for me is PRS. Then, enter the password for the SA user. This password was set when you created the replication server. Replication server interfaces information is marked as complete. This means that you've already added the replication server to the interfaces file. Select Continue to save. Replication server information is now complete. Now, I'll choose database information. In the Database Information window, enter the data server name, which for me is ASE1. Next, enter the password of the SA user on the server, and then enter the database name. For the replication question, answer yes. Then, accept the default maintenance user ID and set a password for it. The replication server logs in to the ASE server using this ID. If you're setting up a warm standby replication system, choose Yes for the last option before continuing. Otherwise, just select Continue. The database information is also complete now, and a new option, Database Replication Agent, has been added. This is because you need a replication agent for a primary database during replication. So, select Database Replication Agent, and then Continue. Next, accept the default user ID, which was made when you created the replication server. The replication agent logs in to the replication server with this ID. Now, enter the password you set for this user when you created the replication server. Then, select Continue to save. Now that you've completed all three options, select Continue to submit everything. Next, choose Yes to start creating the connection from the primary database to the replication server. Wait a few seconds for the process to finish. Select OK when you see the success message. You have now added the primary database to the system. When the connection is created, run the admin who command to check the connection status. Verify that the state of rep agent for the primary database is awaiting command. If you need to add a replicate database, the process is similar to adding a primary database. The only difference is when configuring the database information, you need to select No to set the database as the replicate. And there you have it. For more information about the replication server, see your documentation on the SAP Help Portal. Thanks for watching.